The other thing that I've been following since Swarajya covers a lot of infrastructure projects, especially some of the expressway projects that have been very energetically driven by the current government, at least at the center. So one of the projects that hold huge promise for Odisha is the coastal highway between Gopalpur and Diga, which is like around 450 kilometers, and you've been personally championing that project and suggesting that, you know, that's going to be a huge transformative project for Odisha. But there have been some slight delays in the project in terms of the commissioning. So what do you attribute the delay, and is that a it's kind of caught up in the you know, in a tug of war between the state and the center, and what how soon you see the project is actually going to get commissioned?
You see, Prime Minister Modi, since last 2013, he was campaigning on one issue: unless until the eastern part of India will come up to the standard of western and the southern part of India,
absolutely,
there can be balance developing all over India. So he has given special emphasis in the eastern part of the country, whether it is Bihar, West Bengal, northeastern states, Jharkhand, West Bengal and Odisha. All these states are getting priority in infrastructure project, be it road, be it rail, be it air connectivity, be it other major projects like fertilizer plants, steel plants, coal mining. In all these areas, Government of India is very much focused to bring eastern India at par with the other area of the country. In that project, Odisha is primarily a coastal state.
Absolutely.
450 kilometer coastline is there in Odisha. There is a huge aspirational project. Since our childhood, we are hearing about the coastal highway.
Absolutely.
This coastal highway will expose the maritime activities,
absolutely,
of global community to eastern India. It will come through coast of
coast
Odisha.
Of place, sir.
There are four major ports in coast of Odisha.
Good, sir.
One is by Government of India, Paradip. Another is at Dhamra. It's a private sector
which
port.
Which is coming up, yeah.
Two other ports, Gopalpur and Suvarnarekha. These are the other two major ports can be immersed in the coast of Odisha. This project exactly coming under Bharatmala
with
a stretch of 415 kilometer. Government of India is authorized, is empowered to declare any route, any alignment as National Highway.
Absolutely.
According to National Highway Authority Act 1956, Government of India is competent to declare any area as National Highway.
Absolutely.
Rightly, Government of India in the Bharatmala project identified this piece of land as a coastal highway. Since last 3.5 years, we are pursuing this project in a very vigorous way.
Vigorous.
And we are talking to local government. According to my information, whatever the paper I could see from the Road Transportation Department, twice Government of India given presentation at the Chief Secretary level. In both the time, they have appreciated the project, they have suggested some modification. Rightly, at the Delhi end, Government of India modified them, and finally come out with the final alignment in 2018 July.
Yep.
But the due diligence to be done by Government of Odisha on the land acquisition issue, on the environmental clearance issue, on the giving permission for the CRZ and facilitating to relocate the utilities. All these things has to be taken care of by state government. With repeated request and persuasion by Government of India, state government is not cooperating on the project. At one hand, they are tumtuming, they are for development, they are for welfare of the state. They are seeking more national highway from Prime Minister to take Odisha. In other hand, they are opposing this kind of project on the fear of the goodwill of Prime Minister Modi will increase in Odisha. This is the double standard of local government, especially Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik is main person who is curtailing the development of Odisha.
Stay tuned. In part 3, Dharmendra Pradhan talks about the behavioral change aspect of the success that is the Ujjwala scheme and how he wants to take it forward. Make sure you don't miss it and subscribe to us on YouTube. We'll make it worth your time.